Chetan, the second semi-final sees Australia take on the West Indies. Australia were too good in their group game earlier on in the tournament, but I certainly get the feeling the West Indies have really grown as the tournament's gone on, are perhaps approaching their best, so that must make it a hard game to call.
Yeah, I think, John, it's an equally hard game to call as the Sri Lanka-Pakistan semi-final. If you think that maybe Australia have an advantage, given that they won the first game in the group stages when they played West Indies at Colombo, give them any sort of advantage, I think it's a little bit of a miscalculation on their part. Obviously, Australia have done very, very well as the tournament has progressed, but again, West Indies have also not done that badly either. And if you consider that particular game, on that particular night, West Indies did manage to score 190, one of the highest scores in this particular tournament so far. Yes, Australia were going very, very well. Warner and Watson had given them a very, very good start. And Mike Hussey was also batting like a dream. And when the rain came down by the Duckworth-Lewis method, they were ahead. But we've seen how the middle order, how the Aussie middle order struggles against slow bowlers, against spin bowlers, and just generally struggles. And they have lacked the match practice that they would have otherwise liked, purely because Shane Watson has just been very, very good for them. So you cannot say, you know, if the match had stayed dry and we had had the whole 20 overs in that Australia innings, it would have been a very close chase. We're not sure if Australia would have won or West Indies would have won. Sure, Duckworth-Lewis says Australia were very, very far ahead, 16 or 17 runs ahead. But again, that doesn't make any difference now. Both the teams are again in Colombo. Both will be playing each other on Friday. And a great matchup, I would say. And this is Australia's best chance to prove once and for all that they are also good in the T20 format, that they can do something in the T20 format. They reached the finals last year. Probably they will want to go one better this time. But again, if you look at their one weakness, it's really apparent that they are very, very much dependent on Shane Watson. And Watson just had one failure with the bat. So against Pakistan. So you can count on him that he will be scoring runs again. That failure is now out of the way for him. And given their bowling, I think the makeup of their bowling is quite good, with the fact that Xavier Doherty is now back into the attack along with Granhog. I think they form a good spin attack. Mitchell Starc has been exceptional for Australia in this particular tournament. I think given these conditions, he's been able to swing the ball. And again, towards the end of the innings, he angles them from wide across the stumps, comes round the wicket and angles them in. So he's really settled down and he's bowled really, really well. Pat Cummins is getting into his rhythm. He started off slowly, was very expensive in the initial matches, but now he's getting into the rhythm. Not taking too many wickets, but again, he's been very economical in the last two or three games. And as I said, he's getting into the rhythm. So a well-balanced attack for Australia, probably their other strength than Shane Watson himself. Probably this is where they have the advantage over West Indies, because the West Indies bowling attack, apart from Sunil Narain, and also he's been a little patchy, Sunil Narain, but apart from Narain, they don't really have that huge threat. They have Fiddle Edwards and Rampal starting off, but apart from them and Narain, they don't really have those penetrative wicket-taking. Sure, they have Malan Samuels, who can bowl 120 kph from just two steps away, but I think that remains for the last over or the super over. So probably an edge over West Indies given their bowling. Probably the West Indies have an edge in their batting. They have so many explosive batsmen who are ready to just score huge amounts of runs at any given point of time. But again, if they are to come good, then a whole lot of things have to click for West Indies. And in that particular sense, they are a bit over reliant on Chris Gayle. And if he doesn't fire, then West Indies will be in a lot. If he fires, then probably Shane Watson will also not be able to counter him.
Well, yes, you make the point there about the West Indies perhaps being a bit over-reliant on Chris Gayle. Do you think Australia, on the other hand, are a little over-reliant on Shane Watson with both bat and ball and David Warner at the top of the order, whereas the one game they didn't really fire, they struggled?
Yes, I think that over-reliance is there in both the sides, probably a little more for the West Indies than for Australia, because the Aussie batsmen have not been tested. We don't know. I mean, they've just had the one failure against Pakistan. And it goes to remember well that they have struggled against Pakistan over this past period of time. Even leading up to this tournament, they were struggling against Pakistan. So we can't really say if they will struggle against any other side, which does not boast of so many spinners. Pakistan bowled all five spinners and then only got Umar Gul. West Indies do not have as many spinners. So you can't really say if the Aussie batting, if the Aussie middle order will struggle equally against the West Indies bowling. In that sense, yes, West Indies are a little more reliant on Chris Gayle, because if Gayle gets out early, it just takes out the belief system from West Indies. Yes, they have Malin Samuels and Bravo and Pollard, but they haven't really fired. They have been tested against pace bowling, against spin bowling, and you can't really remember an innings except from probably Samuels and Bravo and maybe Jonathan Charles, who came in with one innings. Apart from that, the lower middle order has not really fired. And that has been both against the spin and pace attacks. Australia, we know they have a weakness against spin, but West Indies do not boast of as many spinners. So I would say West Indies are more reliant on Chris Gayle than Australia are on Shane Watson.
So Jason, I'm going to put you on the spot now. Who's going to win it?
I would put my money on Australia, because given that they are a very mentally strong side, and even if Watson gets out early, they will not lose heart and they'll still try and go for it. And Warner has not had a very, very big innings in this particular tournament. He's made some starts, but he's not come good. So I would put my money on Warner and Hussey to see them through. So Australia for me here.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go and agree with you, Chetan, and not just because you're leading our prediction league. I think they'll bounce back from their defeat to Pakistan. They didn't enjoy that one little bit, so they'll be too strong for me as well.